Alright, howdy y'all, this is the next game on the wheel. It is Heart&Slash. This was gifted me a long time ago by ShiftKey Girl, I want to say. Never got around to it, but I started this game yesterday just to make sure it would work and it was capturable and everything, doing my normal pre-stream checks. And then accidentally played it for 2 hours. So it's pretty good. I like it a lot. It really caught me off guard. I had to do some finagling to get it to load without any of my saves, so I have everything relocked. I'll probably play a little bit and then load my save back in so that everything re-unlocks. But let's just get into it, because there's a tutorial. The tutorial, it's good and it teaches you stuff. It says story too, but yeah, we'll do the tutorial real quick. So we'll say the tutorial is probably the weakest part of the game. I know that sounds dumb, but like I almost was put off from the game by it because the humor is a little iffy and it's pretty slow. So you are robot. HRT1, that is our name. I will say up front, this is one that might be a little tough to quote-unquote finish because it is a roguelike, so we will see. I'll probably just play like a really good amount of it and then call it. That will not be hard. And yeah, so there's camera and click to control. There's no lock on stuff, which feels weird at first, but I got pretty used to it. So one thing I will say is this game's real fast. You're going to see exactly how fast it is. I believe this was kickstarted. It was in early access for a long time. I don't know if it still is. But yeah, the tutorial has some kind of dead air in it that kills it a little bit. But you're just going to have to trust and stick with me. So first of all, this is how fast you go. Normally, this is your normal move speed. You have a huge double jump. And then here's your sprint. For like moving between areas fast, so you're real fast. And here comes the meat and potatoes. And so you get to equip 3 weapons at a time. And it is weak attacks and strong attacks. It's obviously not quite to the level of platinum, but it is to a platinum-esque style. There are different weapon combos for each one. A lot of them, just heavy attack on its own is your launcher. It says most, but in my experience, it's actually not that many of them. But your basic swords, it is. Also, you can do a lot of air combos. Once you knock people into the air, you'll follow them automatically. But we're going to get to the really interesting part of the combat here in a second. Which is this, and I'll put this in the left slot, and this in the right slot. Thanks for the follow, Drinking Games Chaos. main weapon, and then your left and right. So I'll run through this a little quicker. You equip them by holding a bumper, and so you can like really switch between them quickly. So you can do like 1, 2, and then third strike with the lightning one, or same thing with the fire blade. And Fireblade has a special, so you can use that to raise people in the air and then pick a weapon with a little more oomph mid-combo. So like if you use forward and strong attack at the same time with a Fireblade, that big boy, and then do a little combo there, and then lightning for the finisher is real good. So a lot of very, very fast mid-combo stuff. So you do have a dodge roll. The dodge roll is super important across the board. Enemies usually will have a tell if they're about to attack. You really need to use those up slashes a lot because they have a lot of knockdown. And yeah, we're going to... I'm pretty sure this is scripted to be a 100% loss fight. Thanks for the follow, Intrigate. And we will see... Yeah, this is a scripted loss. But there are elemental weaknesses. The only downside to that is as it is a roguelike, a lot of times you will just not get them. And this guy has a rare thing where he switches between weaknesses. The camera is a little bit fidgety sometimes. A lot of times it'll kind of end up... Usually it's pretty good about staying out of walls. For some reason, the tutorial area is one of the worst about it. Which is weird of all things to have trouble with. It's the tutorial area seems to be the worst about it. But it is very much a you have to control your own camera. It feels weird not having lock on, but one-on-one fights like this are basically the tutorial. Quite frankly, like for the most part, you will not see those outside of the tutorial here. And so we find out the QA system overtakes stuff. And again, don't worry, the text placement is pretty... If you're talking about the text boxes, those don't come up that often. It's weird because the tutorial does give you a rundown of everything pretty quickly, but it feels super separate from the rest of the game. The biggest one being, when you're fighting people, usually you're fighting 5, 10, it's a lot. Also, yeah, we're gonna get our butts beat automatically here. But as you can see, dodge is super crucial. Your dodge is pretty far. It's a pretty safe dodge across the board. Like, you can roll into attacks. Why is this an auto lose now? Ah, oh, dang it. Whoop. Okay, I think he just healed, so. Yeah, so you can get around a lot of toughness though from combat. So, God, I hate using the lazy analogies, which there's a few of them that I consider super lazy. Binding of Isaac being one of them, but the gameplay is very Binding of Isaac-y. It's very influenced by it as far as like the layout, the natural flow of the way things work. It's much faster, and obviously the combat is way higher paced than any of that. But the nice thing is the tutorial jumps you right into the game. This opening happens every time, but you can just skip it by pressing start and jump right into the game. Also, we're going to hear the stage one music track soon, which is... Molto Dendi. It is so fucking good. I love the music in this game. I've actually only been able to get to stage 2 so far. It's hard. And here's where a lot of this stuff comes in and gets a little tougher is there are random drops for equipment here. We got one that I'm not a big fan of, was the kinetic repeller. And the shield, which has a parry, which is pretty good. And a lot of this stuff is skippable. But he's basically saying, like, hey, you're awake again. You should probably move. And here comes the music, which is great. So the huge advantage to fighting enemies, and the reason you're going to want to, is on top of obviously safety, you could run by a lot of enemies, but they give you kind of bolts, which are the currency of the game. And we don't have enough to do anything, but as soon as we do, I'll show you all the menus for it and what they're good for. beams in general are really dangerous. There are missile enemies. You can hit them back, though. At first, I thought it was exclusive to a certain weapon because, hey, let's just say I got a baseball bat. It is not exclusive to the baseball bat. Any melee weapon can knock back missiles, which is pretty nice. Well, the move speed's good, and if you're just trying to get between rooms, there's actually a faster move, too. If you hold left and right bumper, both weapon selects, you just fucking cheese it. You are so there. Early on, a lot of the enemies only take a couple hits and we only have a couple small guys. The enemy variety ramps up really quickly. And we have two rooms with exclamation points, so let's check those out. Oh, nice. So there is a computer on the first floor always. This one always seems to show up. And he's telling you, hey, you need to upgrade a piece of equipment. We don't have enough bolts yet, so I will do that as soon as we do. Oh, wow. Are there two of them in this stage? Oh. Yeah, this got a release on PS4 and Xbox One. I can't speak to the stability or anything of those versions, as this is a pretty small early access game, but I can say that the PC version has been really good to me so far. Dang it, I actually took a hit. One thing is, as this is a roguelike of sorts, your health is at a super high premium, but we got enough stuff to upgrade something, so we have a lot of upgrades. Sometimes they're a little unclear, but you can upgrade any piece of your equipment, including like your shield there. All of those have a cost, and the cost is usually in like cardboard boxes of bolts. I'm pretty sure all of the ones for heart, meaning main character, just give you more health, which is really good, obviously. Kinetic propeller I've never looked at, but push bigger enemies, damage as you push, lower recharge time, that seems pretty good. But we are gonna go ahead and just get an upgrade for the steel slicer here, because it is my base weapon. Higher damage is fantastic in this game. Most of my best runs were ones where I managed to get my weapons all leveled up really quickly. All right. And here's the other thing. As you do quests, which are kind of like the little mini chivos in the game, that's how you unlock more weapons, which is really good. So we actually just got there the blade on a stick. Blade on a stick, which is basically just a spear. And it's got a very kind of expected set of spear moves, but the nice thing is it does add a lot of variety. So we can switch mid attack cycle, like I said. There's a lot of ways to mix this up, since you do carry your heavy and weak attacks between them. Oh, hello. Any enemy that has a heart over their head like that will actually drop health when defeated, which is really, like, those are priority, obviously. I say as I hit another enemy while they're electrocuted. Enemies do have pretty long windups on attacks. A lot of this game is just kind of being careful and dodging a lot. And I got really lucky. I've actually never seen this happen before with two of these. So I don't really want to blade on a stick. So what you can do is you can recycle parts. And what the recycling unit does is just you eat a piece of equipment and gain health back, kind of like a robot in Nuclear Throne. I don't know if you have an air dodge. I can't remember. I know I try to mash it a lot. I reflexively try to have one. The other nice thing, too, is if you invest in a piece of equipment, it actually ups the recycle value. So there are ways to get more health back. So if you do have a lot of health available to you because you upgraded the main unit and you have a lot of like a really strong weapon and you're really in a bind, you can get rid of it, obviously at the cost of losing the weapon. You're never really back against the wall until you're entirely out of gear. And the movement speed really does help He's in a dungeon. So sometimes you'll have a room just locked down. You just have to beat every enemy before you can leave. So now we got some bigger enemies. These are the guys that really using your combos and your whoop. Knockups is huge. Another thing here is to note is enemies can hit each other, particularly projectile enemies. It's really good to take advantage of, since some of them are really easy to lead into certain attacks. Yeah, the downside right now to our loadout is we only really have, like, basic weapons. We don't have any elemental, so if we run into something that resists it, we just kind of gotta deal with it. And we can upgrade that more. And we could upgrade the shield that I just haven't used at all, because I'm not that I'm not that confident in it, but it does have a little parry. But yeah, friendly fire is really good in this game. There's an enemy set in stage 2 that I can just get them all to just murder each other, which is fantastic. And it's really reliable, and they're otherwise pretty intimidating enemies, so having them just remove each other from the fight is just fantastic, load off my mind. And yeah, so these areas do deploy enemies. Falling down is not instant death, it's just half a heart of damage. So areas like this, you do have to be careful of falling down pits, but it's not like end of the world if you don't, if you do fall down. And you do have a double jump, so you can make a swing and then jump back. Or you can just fall down a pit. That's your choices. It's really up to you. And as you can see, I'm unlocking stuff pretty quickly, partially because I do have like 2 hours into this game already, so I'm pretty decent at the combat. I could just start a fresh save, but if I do go back into Steam, it'll re-unlock everything right now. And I almost want to die just so I can show off some of the other weapons, because, oh man, there's a lot of really good ones. And I actually just unlocked one of my favorites. I think the shield is functional, unlike like Bloodborne's, but it is not super good. It's just risky, because, you know, you could shield or you could just, you know, get on top of your enemies and not really let them move. God, I'm trying to use the spear, but it is really hard. I think I need to go back around the other way, I think. And again, thank goodness for the move speed being obscene, especially if you hold both bumpers and do the little dash. Because you don't even have to hold forward, it's just an auto run as soon as you hold both of them. And yeah, those little guys really aren't much of a hazard. I'm glad I made that long. Yeah. I accidentally just upgraded, but that's fine. While I put my face, my hands in my face. But yeah. I'm glad people got scared by it. Well, luckily we're moving to a boss fight right now. I thought I had cut it shorter than that. I did not. Well, thank you so much for the donation, by the way. But yeah, so there are a couple small fights. This is kind of more like a mini boss fight. Hopefully we will get to a boss proper. I think we will. We might lose to him though, because the bosses are really hard. Let's try to parry this guy. Let's see how that goes. Come on, Slash. There we go. Yeah, see, so like I did, I got the block at least. I don't know if I got the parry. Yeah, so the parry doesn't seem very good. Slash is pretty easy to beat though. So actually, just to, you know, I've always accidentally like overswung and killed Slash every time I fight him, so I'm gonna not do it this time. No. Oh, nice, that unlocks the thing. You can use guns. I just haven't found any yet. I don't even know if I've unlocked any yet. Yeah, big guys are oddly not dangerous in general. They hit like a truck, so you do have to be careful, but they're pretty slow. They're very predictable. They take a bunch of hits, but they're super juggleable. And you can just pile the damage on. They get really dangerous when they're in crowds is the main thing, because they make it really hard to deal with other stuff. Then we have healer robots, which unfortunately you cannot trick into firing at you, no matter how hard you try. But when you get small units like that, you'll get like defense buff ones, and you'll get healer ones, and I don't know if there's any others. There probably are. But it is important to take those out first, because otherwise you're just going to be fighting enemies that just regen health constantly. Nice, we have an equipment room next door, so we will be getting another piece. Yeah, the biggest risk here is that drill guy interrupting me mid-attack. Yeah, and a ton of attacks are interruptible. The Steel Slicer is actually really good. It's your kind of most basic weapon in the game, but holy cow, it is excellent. I would almost say, in every run I've had so far, it's worth upgrading my main weapon immediately. And we got Volt Bracers, which, in my opinion, are better. We will be able to really quickly pick up and eat the Kinetic Repeller. So those just give you resistance to elements. They are great if you level them up, because you can just get like 75% resistance to electric damage, which is as good as it sounds, quite frankly. Oh shit, yeah, I like the Rocket Hammer. Okay, the Rocket Hammer is like one of my favorites. Oh yeah, and all weapons are visual. So you can see what you have equipped at all times.
Is this the game you accidentally played for 2 hours last night?
No, yeah. I did not mean to do that. Okay, and there is a map that you can look at. So if you do get a little lost, it is there. Yeah, like it's kind of like a Platinum Binding Isaac, and again, I hate lazy comparisons, but it really is. It's pretty tough, and the combat's really smooth. And
how many stages are in the game?
I'm not sure. I've gotten partway through stage 2 and died. that's it. I have now nice. Though beat every boss, so of stage 1 I mean. Because again, there are multiple bosses, and a couple of them are real fucking hard. Some of them I don't even know how you're supposed to beat without getting hit yet. And yeah, my first run's going pretty well, so I'm getting a lot of unlocks. I'll show the full unlock menu after this run ends. Holy shit, I don't even think I had that unlocked before. Damn, do I need to use this unlock now? I wonder if I can load this, because I was just planning on doing a quick run and then loading my save file back in. And launching it through Steam. Oh no. Oh no. Am I gonna lose progress now? No. But yeah, there's some other stuff that's really nice too that I haven't been able to show off yet. So, in kind of a Rogue Legacy-esque fashion, I'm not sure if there's a cap, but if you don't spend money during one run, it'll let you keep it for the next run. So if you really want to like go all in and be like, okay, I'm gonna do this. This next run is happening. I'm gonna win this next run. You can just save all your money. Also, there we go, reflecting back some missiles at an enemy. So if you want, you can start a run. I think I started one with like 5 at one point, just so I started and immediately had full quality gear. Ah, the rubber duck, which does nothing. I have fully upgraded the rubber duck before. It does nothing. I don't know. It maybe does something somewhere, but I've yet to find it. All right, so this unlock room's a little different. All the computer stuff are like little challenges you can do. They seem optional at this point. Yeah, you're probably going to need to put it on source for this, or else you're just not going to be able to see stuff. This room's a little challenging because we have a lot of guys in full armor, which are pretty tough to deal with. And also this huge missile launcher. So I'm going to try and bait the missile launcher out. Oh, another nice thing about this game, no contact damage from like almost anything. So if you want to just mess this dude up first, you can just jump between them. But I want to see if I can't have him mess up some other guys first for me. Kind of bait.
I like how you can do the exact same strategy that you can do in PSO1 with these guys.
What do you mean? Just jump up on them and smack them from the inside?
No. The giant missile launcher tanks, you just point them around and have them shoot missiles at everything else in the room.
There we go. Yes. 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 So he is obviously a pretty big threat because those missiles do a lot of damage and there are many of them. Okay, so I accidentally took out the big guy first because I made him hit himself. Shield armor guys are a huge pain. I need to figure out how to deal with them better at this point. Because right now I just kind of heart attack to knock off a piece of equipment. And you can knock off their armor, but you still just bounce off after a hit. I think maybe if I had their weaknesses elemental-wise, it would maybe break off more. But it seems like if you just use the uppercut a couple times, you can smack off a lot of armor really quickly. And if you get the angle right, you'll just kind of rub up against them and take all their armor off.
I've been watching for a bit. It seems like the uppercut almost takes you a little too high against certain enemies.
It depends. Like, if they're already airborne, yeah, you can easily pass an enemy up. In which case, it's probably better to just jump in the air and try and take them out that way. But against most enemies, you can just hold the jump and then immediately do that. There we go. Oh, thank goodness. I took a lot of damage there. That was less than good. But let's see. What do you got for me, buddy? Short gun. The short gun kind of sucks. It's a gun. What do you expect? You have to manually reload it. It starts with only one shot in the chamber. It is nice as a combo finisher because the air shot does just kind of hit whatever. But it doesn't do a lot of damage. In fact, it just doesn't do like enough damage, really. And let's get here. Improved. The other nice thing too is when you buy the health upgrades, which again, the upgrade menu is just, you have it. You just always have the upgrade menu. I'm gonna go with an extra shot in the chamber and a quick reload. But yeah, you can just like, so if you haven't bought all the health upgrades and you need some, you just fucking do that. And just be like, I would like more health, please. Thank you.
I just saw the upgrades for the rubber duck. No, seriously, you're wasting your money.
Yeah, stop it. And I did upgrade the rubber duck all the way at one point. Yeah, it didn't do anything. I was like, this seems like a trick. Actually, it seems like the shotgun might blow all their armor off. Holy shit, is that what it... Oh my god, that'd be amazing. Holy shit, it does. Oh my god. Okay, I like this gun now. I have immediately turned around my opinion on the shotgun. Not to mention the air shot like hits basically whatever you need it to. But yeah, game can get really frantic really quickly. Whoop. And yeah, guns aren't super strong, partially because they can't be. Otherwise it would just bust the game wide open. There might be a gun that is very good, because there are a ton of weapons. I'll show the whole unlock menu, and you can kind of just be like, that's a lot of shit. Again, very Binding Isaac-y in that regard. There is a lot of stuff to unlock. The nice thing about Binding, or about this relative to Binding Isaac, is the unlock conditions are things, it seems like right now, that you would just do normally. There's no, like, ridiculous challenge. It's like, kill 50 of these guys. Okay, you get a piece of equipment. Like, here you go. You can now find this on subsequent runs. And yeah, as you go on, you find upgrade material pretty quickly. I'm amazed I haven't found the end of the level yet, actually. It was like a really big first level. Get some easy shots out of here. Oh. Okay, I want to kill that guy because he's got... Oh, I say I want to kill this dude because he's got a heart, and then I immediately take a hit for it. Dang. Classical hubris, my dude. But yeah, each stage is pretty large. Again, alleviated by the fact that the music is pretty excellent.
Now, you've been on stage one this whole run, right?
Basically, I did the tutorial first.
Yeah.
And also, I am killing literally every person I come across to try and build up a bit of a reserve, also to get unlocks, since I have none of the unlocks yet. Oops, forgot to reload. Damn, that's another unlock I never had before. How am I finding all these new unlocks that I never got? What am I doing? Yeah, I can't wait to... I really hope I get to level 2 now. I'm worried I'm going to die, because the bosses are real hard, by the way. The bosses are a pretty huge step up. But yeah, like, if you think you're ready and you're like, I could just go to the boss next, you can just sprint to him. The biggest downside being you don't have, you know, as much currency as you would, but you honestly can get way more than you need. You don't need to fight everybody.
Yeah, because you mentioned you can carry currency over from other runs, right?
Uh-huh. So if you really wanted to and you had one where you just kind of like stockpiled, or you got like 5 things but then just never spent it and died, you can just basically blitz through Area 1 then on your next run. Like, you'll have the couple rooms that lock down, but if the room doesn't show that big animation of like warning, warning, and locking down all the doors, you can just leave. you can just go.
Right.
Dang it.
I like the option is there that you can just kind of rush through.
Mm-hmm. Oh my gosh, how have I not found the... Where could it possibly be? Now I'm just confused. I've never had this trouble before. This trouble of where? Well, I have so much money, though, which is nice. I'll probably just get more health upgrades before the boss. Also, there's other unlockable characters. I have not found any of them yet. I don't know what they could possibly be. All right, let's look at this map. Okay, luckily there's like, this place is huge. I don't know if I got an extra large deluxe floor or something, but holy cow.
Do those exist?
I don't know. Maybe. No, there's no gimmick for time in levels. You don't get punished for taking too long or anything. Oop. Gonna hop over these boys. Gonna rush for...
Oh, rooms can stack on top of each other. That's why. I was like, I'm looking at the map and I see these two rooms just kind of intersecting.
Yeah, there
we
are...
We need space.
You can have multiple floors. Okay, there's the boss. Good. Oh, it's this boss too. Good. This is one that I'm pretty confident about fighting. I'm somewhat confident. Oh, Also, I think there's a different level too, depending, and I think it's depending on which boss you fight. Oh god, lunge. Oh. Okay, actually managed to dodge that from the inside. Did not manage to dodge that one. Obviously that attack's real tough because it's got a shockwave out of it. It's kind of the forward dash spring. I'm getting greedy is my biggest problem here. There are tells. Again, the fights are all super fast just because the movement speed. Everything about this game is fast. Like, if there was one word I would use to describe it the most as far as the pace and everything, this game is never... It does not breathe, which is good or bad depending on if you can keep up and deal with that kind of thing. Obviously, if it is your shit, it is extremely your shit. My biggest gripe is I think some of the bosses have a bit too much health. I don't know if that's an elemental weakness thing or not. But even when I did really well, some of the fights just take a while.
There's no health bar or anything that you can tell, or do they start flashing?
Yeah, that's kind of the other. Yeah, they'll start like flashing and they signal when they're taking damage. And one of the first floor bosses has like three distinct forms where they change like attack style and stuff. Not the one I got here, but yeah, they're pretty clear. I think this guy's weak to fire, but unfortunately, I didn't get any. Yeah, I'm not sure if there is a different way to do this fight that makes it a little quicker or not. Because this guy takes a lot of hits, and like, remember, I have my sword fully upgraded too. I don't even want to know how long it would take if I didn't.
I do like that the boss has pretty clear tells.
Yeah, I mean, they have, yeah, it's like a pretty good wind up. The exclamation, okay, yeah, he's almost dead. This is also, like, as much as I like the slicer for utility, it is not a particularly strong weapon. There are things like the Thunder Hammer that are a bit... They do a lot more damage a lot more quickly, and I don't really have any of those heavy weapons. But yeah, he's almost done. There we go. Nice, first go. And I also was kind of baiting out certain attacks. He has more than that, but I was trying to stick in certain zones, more or less, to try and kind of bait out certain moves. And yeah, so I think it's just if you beat Frankie Y or whatever, it takes you down to the sewer. Which, a good-looking sewer, what the? I'm gonna try and look for more equipment post-haste. We can get some of the more interesting pieces. Gosh. These quick guys are a nightmare. And yeah, I'm starting to see a lot of enemies resisting what I have, so getting no elemental gear is like kind of starting to bust up my run a little bit. But gun is really good for like quick interrupts.
Feels like Devil May Cry, where like the guns are situationally useful, but not things you rely on.
Yeah. Well, the main thing is it doesn't do a ton of damage, but it, wow, the knockback on it is really good. I didn't really mess with the guns much, so I'm learning as I go still.
What have you found so far? The shotgun?
God, I can't can't remember. I think on my other file I picked up one at some point, but I died pretty shortly thereafter, so I didn't really have much time with it. But yeah, I'm gonna sprint for equipment and see if I can find something. Also, man, the other stage one area I have found is a real sharp contrast to this. Whereas this is like kind of tight corridors and feels pretty locked down. The other one I was in was super huge and open. Oh, geez. Okay, in fact, I'm going to eat my blade on the stick here. And probably my volt bracers too, because they're not really doing a whole lot for me. Okay. So again, you can just ditch equipment for health if you're desperate. Not that anyone here
is. Oh, wow, those guys hurt a lot.
Desperate. Yeah, you start getting guys who hurt a lot more. Yeah, it might be the tells the yellow and red are actually what you can and cannot interrupt. Oh, is there a floor above me that has equipment? That is the case. I'm running the fuck upstairs. Hello. Hello, are you gear? Even farther upstairs? Oh! I'm in the city now. I'm just in an entirely different area. Oh god, these enemies, okay. Okay, so apparently the sewer and that are connected.
It's good that there's variation inside the levels as well. Yeah. Not just the ones through the tile set, because that would get really old really fast.
I did not know that those were interconnected, so hey, you learn something every day, I suppose. Oh, geez, though, I am low on health and I need to get that. Where's the equipment? Where's the equipment? It might be us to beat these guys to get it, which would really suck for me. I really need to kind of bait these lasers around. They're real good at killing themselves. Run. Oh, jeez. That one's blown up. Are any of these up still? No. Okay. Okay. Oh yeah, shotgun. Oh no, I took a hit. That's bad. It seems like projectiles are always, in general, pretty forgiving. Like, if they don't have a huge tell, they only do half a heart. Oh my gosh, this one is kicking my ass, though. And as you can see, I have considerably less experience in stage two than I have in stage one. And it shows. I'm not really sure how to handle stuff yet. Wawa. Oh no, I summoned more things. Okay, luckily it's missile pods, which are pretty easy to deal with as soon as you realize they can hit themselves.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, where? Where is thing? There's an upgrade in here somewhere, and I don't know if I have to beat enemies or if it'll just show up. Oh, you can just hit him in the ground. Okay, that's good. Allegedly, there's another piece of equipment in a smaller area nearby. I probably should go for that one first. Whoa, jeez, I got hit. man. Well, that was a really long first run. All right. Yeah, let's go into the unlocks we have so far. Like I said, some of them are just like upgrade a weapon and you unlock halberds and bats. Unlock the shotgun by surviving a challenge. Unlock a cleaver by don't be mean. Clean the remnant.
I like how you unlock a weapon for being nice.
Yeah, being nice, yeah. defeat 10 small bots, defeat 25 small bots, 100, like there's all sorts of stuff. There are a ton of them, and whoa, that was the one I got. Eye of the Tiger was survived for 20 minutes. That run lasted so long. 15 hearts of max health. And that's the one that was really good, was Rocket Hammer. Rocket Hammer rules. And then you can see all the pieces of equipment. There are 135 pieces of equipment. So there's a lot.
So it looks like some of them are saying, like, Frankie set, Clockwork set. Are those, like, other pieces of armor, too, or are those just cosmetic?
I think there are pieces of armor you can find.
Oh.
Yeah, because, like, there's all these things that I have unlocked, but I have not found. And then enemies, too. You see all the variants. There's 93 variants of enemies. And, you know, also bosses. I like how you immediately go Frank Z because fucking game's done quick, man. But yeah. So again, it's nice that you can just start your run right away. And I want to know how to unlock more characters, but I have yet to find one. So actually, wait. You know what? I almost forgot. I need to restore my save real quick. And then, launch through Steam, because otherwise I'll mess this all up. So.